is KYW News 3 at 6.
Tonight, a blast of winter heads into our area after socking parts of the South with snow and ice. Good evening, I'm Dawn Stensel, and Larry Kane has the night off. And we are really bracing tonight for the first big winter storm of the season as a powerful nor'easter churns its way up the East Coast. Now, the worst for many of us may come in the form of heavy rain and wind. And also at the beach in Avalon, flooding is a big concern. And also at the Jersey Shore and other parts of our area tonight. For the latest now on the storm, let's get right to Carol Erickson in the KYW Storm Center. Carol, I guess it could have been a lot worse though, right?
It could have been. If you wanted snow and you live in the greater Philadelphia area, you're out of luck. But if you wanted rain, you must be ecstatic. We are getting some very heavy rain, and it will continue to be heavy for the next several hours at least. There is snow though. This nor'easter did come true for some people. Its inland track took that snow over to the west, and you can see it here on Snowcast, who's getting what. Also, you can see the very heavy rain indicated by all that yellow going through sections of South Jersey. In fact, take a look at our radar. This is a fast-moving storm. This is just the last couple of hours, and you can see that Atlantic and portions of Gloucester and Camden and Burlington counties getting hit with some very heavy rain right now. And down at the shore, they're probably getting some horizontal wind and rain. So it's going to be an interesting night for the South Poconos and the Lehigh Valley. It looks like 1 to 4 inches of snow possible. This would be towards daybreak when the changeover occurs for the northern Poconos and northeastern Pennsylvania. They could be seeing 6 to 10 inches of snow possible. So windy continuing down along the shore, rain for everybody else, and then that snow as you go far to the north and west. A coastal flood warning is in effect for the New Jersey and Delaware shores. Tides 2 feet above normal. Some minor to moderate tidal flooding at the time of high tide tonight, and that's about in an hour or so between 7 and 8 p.m. down along the Jersey shore tonight, and it will be a much less of a problem tomorrow morning at that high tide. And I'll get into all of this and all the rest of this fast-moving, kind of exhausting storm when I come back. We'll go back to you now, Dawn.
Thanks, Carol. See you in about 10 minutes. Now, the coastal flood warning is also in effect for all of Delaware's coast, but inland, things seem to be pretty calm so far. Let's go live now to News 3's Marge Palla in Wilmington. Marge, how are things out there?
Well, you know, Dawn, at this point, I'd expect it to be ankle-deep in snow. Of course, at 5'2", ankle-deep's only about an inch and a half. But nevertheless, mercifully, the precipitation inland in Delaware turned out to be just plain rain. So instead of snow plows and sand pits, all you need to weather this storm are windshield wipers and umbrellas. The day in Delaware started out sunny, but turned cloudy by noon and downright gloomy by 4 o'clock when the rain started to fall, just in time to complicate the afternoon rush hour. But with the prospect of snow and sleet hanging over our heads all day, commuters almost welcomed the rain, which seems benign by comparison. Now, of course, snow had been predicted, so Wilmington's Public Works Department was in a high state of readiness. They had pre-mixed tons and tons of sand and salt, and they have 6 new, brand new white plow trucks. I think that they were actually trying and dying to get out there and try out. Unfortunately, tonight will not be the night they need plow trucks out here. Reporting live from Rodney Square in Wilmington, I'm Marge Pallett. We'll go back to you in the studio.
Thank you, Marge. The wet weather could mean slick roads in some parts of our area, though. News 3's Walt Hunter is live right now in Valley Forge with more on that part of the story. Walt.
Dawn, we're live where the expressway turns into the turnpike in Upper Merion. The good news is what we're not hearing on the police scanners. No reports of any serious accidents. When this rain started falling out here around 4 o'clock, it didn't glaze the roads. It simply made them wet. But that made driving pretty miserable, especially on a stretch of Route 202 right here near the King of Prussia Malls. Take a look at this. This was rush hour, actually more like crawl hour around 4 o'clock. Even with everybody off for a lot of the holidays, traffic still came along very, very slowly with the heavy rain. People obviously taking it easy and using caution here along 202. This is normally a congested area anyway. Earlier over at PennDOT headquarters in Hunting Park, they were very, very busy preparing for what could have been a snow emergency. They were busy getting their salt and their sand stockpiled throughout the morning and early afternoon, keeping a close eye on the weather charts, because when you talk to Frank Graff, who is the district manager for Philadelphia, he'll be quick to tell you, you never really know what a nor'easter is going to do.
We're watching the edge of the storm. They're saying it's going to be west of us toward the middle Pennsylvania and out. And I've seen them things change in the last hour. So we have to go with the worst forecast we hear. And that's what we're thinking right now.
And the good news is we look west on the expressway here toward the turnpike. If you're headed out to Chester County, Upper Montgomery County, the snow line is far away. The rain is hitting, but it's only forming puddles. Be careful. But the good news is you won't find any ice. That's it live from King of Prussia. We'll go back into you, Don.
Okay, thank you, Walt. Now, the biggest concern in our area right now is at the Jersey Shore, where heavy rain has already started. News 3's Robin McIntosh reports.
It was a morning to watch and wait, prepared for the worst, hoping for the best. In Atlantic City, the Ocean End Beach were picture perfect in the morning, only to turn ugly by midday. City officials had spent weeks and thousands of dollars this fall on geotubes to keep the sand in and the ocean out, hoping they will hold back their first nor'easter.
We have put some public works heavy equipment on standby just in case we need to get into flood-prone areas for any type of emergencies.
For beachfront buildings, word of approaching high tides and higher winds, enough warning to think about evacuations, especially at the Oceanside Convalescent Center, where seniors enjoy a summery boardwalk view, but too close for comfort in a winter storm.
We haven't received any notice from the emergency management of Atlantic City that we do have to evacuate, so we're just on the alert.
By mid-afternoon, the rains came down, the wind picked up, and the sea turned from calm to angry as local seashore residents and emergency management coordinators kept one eye on the horizon, the other on local weather forecasts.
So when you come into town, you get hit with it. Then when you turn right, you then have road flooded.
In Avalon, emergency management coordinator Harry DeButz rallied his troops just in case. The North End Beach already swept away by earlier nor'easters.
I'm mainly concerned about beach erosion. Thankfully, it looks as though this thing may move through at the time of low tide overnight and not have as devastating an impact as it would if it were at the full tide.
In Sea Isle City, a $165,000 emergency beach replenishment project and geotubes installed this month came just in time for one beachfront condo.
It's going to be the first test. We're going to see how the geotubes are going to hold up. But obviously we're a lot better than we were when we had our first two nor'easters in the fall.
And we are now live in Avalon, New Jersey. You're looking at a live picture of a very angry surf and heavy winds that are pounding Avalon along with all the other South Jersey communities down here at the shore. A little bit of advice. If you're down here, you have a car, move it to higher ground. If you have anything outside the house, move it inside or batten it down. Because right now, this rain is literally blowing sideways. The surf is very powerful. There's flooding expected later on tonight. Right now, no evacuations to report, though. The news is good on that front, but this rain continues to come down and the winds are beginning to pick up. That's the story live from Avalon, and Dawn, we'll go back to you.
Thank you, Robin, and you get inside and dry off. So that wraps up our storm coverage for right now. Of course, Carol Erickson will have more on our forecast just a little bit later. Plus, we'll have the latest on this winter blast tonight on News 3 at 11 with Larry Kane. And listen to KYW.
Great night, unfortunately, to go out to see the Celebration of Lights at Core Creek Park, but it'll be on through January the 11th. So if you can get out there, it's a wonderful thing to see. The number to call for more information, 757-0571. Wow, look what has been barreling up the East Coast today. This low pressure center started in the south. It's heading up towards us, and it is over us right now. It is dragging in lots of moisture from the Atlantic Ocean, and that's the good news, because that moisture is warm, and that is keeping most of us in a rain pattern, but lots of heavy rain. You may have seen Robin McIntosh's live shot at the beginning of this show. That rain was coming straight at him. It was a horizontal rain, and that's what you're getting, because you're getting some winds of about 28 miles an hour now down along the shore. That's nothing compared to what they will be getting later on. You can see who's getting the problem right now. Lots of heavy rain moving through South Jersey. It is moving in a northerly direction, so heavy rain through this whole area. This is the mixed precipitation way out to the west. They are getting that snow, so this is a very significant winter storm. Just the last couple of hours, look how it moved in and took over, and we can see right now that lots of areas in South Jersey and also now in Bucks and Montgomery counties, they're starting to get some of that heavy rain as well. We can be expecting this rainy pattern throughout the night, but breaks are coming. Here's the good news. Look at the temperatures. They're in the 40s. Can you imagine if we dropped them down about 10 degrees, what would be happening? It would be unbelievable. But with temperatures this high, not cold enough to support any snow, so certainly we're not having any right now. But We could be seeing a little of that. In the South Poconos, the Southern Poconos, the Lehigh Valley, they could be getting, before this is all over by tomorrow around daybreak, 1 to 4 inches of snow possible in the Northern Poconos and Northeastern Pennsylvania, 6 to 10 inches of snow possible. So some in Eastern Pennsylvania will be seeing a little bit of this. For everybody else, just windy, 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 and rain, and then a tiny bit of a possibility of a mix. As you go out towards way out in Northern Bucks County, you might see a little bit of a mix as the evening wears on. Now, coastal flood warning in effect. Tides 2 feet above normal, minor to moderate tidal flooding at the time of high tide tonight. That's between 7 and 8 generally along the Jersey Shore. It'll be a nuisance flooding situation on Tuesday. That's because the winds will shift and they'll just help to push the water out, and they will not be able to stack in as if as it's going to be doing tonight. So rain out there and 40 degrees, northeasterly winds 18 miles an hour now. Heavy rain at times tonight and continuing windy, 35 to 38 degrees. Then tomorrow, windy, colder, a chance of morning rain, maybe even some afternoon snow, a 38 degree temperature. That's the high for the day. It'll come in the morning. Temperatures will drop as the day progresses to 25 degrees. Last day of the year, cold and dry. In fact, we will see out this year and the new year coming in with very, very cold temperatures and a very wet night coming up for us tonight. Don, we'll go back.
Now on the Weather Channel, your local forecast.
Storm chugging up the eastern seaboard, bringing all its baggage with it, potentially some pretty serious flooding in western Long Island Sound later on tonight. In addition, crippling snows in the Appalachians and even some snow lingering in the Piedmont and the Carolinas down into North Georgia. Let's get the latest on the situation and where it's all headed. For that, let's go to Mike Bono in the Forecast Center.
Thanks a lot, Bill. Yes, there has been some snow in the south and some snow in the Appalachians and a lot of wind and rain on the east coast. Let's take a look at our map right now and we'll show you where the major players are located. High pressure is usually a player, and there's one moving out over Newfoundland and Nova Scotia with some wind coming on down from Canada. And then the isobars get kind of thick and closely spaced north of our newly developing low along the coastline. That's a rainstorm, and it's got some gales associated with it. And to the west of, oh, about Richmond and Raleigh and on into Harrisburg, PA, you're getting some snow in the mountains, all of which we will cover. But our own Mike Seidel has been braving the wind and the rain on Wildwood or in Sandy Hook, New Jersey. And Jim Cantore now has arrived on the scene in Bedford, Pennsylvania. Good evening to both of you. Jim, how's the snow going? Have you had much on the ground yet?
Well, Mike, I'll be honest with you. About an hour ago, I had what they call a flashback, and I remember times like this as growing up like a kid, when you would think there's going to be like a foot of snow on the ground at 2 o'clock in the morning and you can't sleep all night and you get up and nothing has happened. That's kind of a similar scenario right now. And we're in what we call the dry slot. As the upper storm over the United States matures, the dry air wraps around it. And that's where we are, in this dry slot. And as you know, from talking to Mike and actually dealing with what's going on the radar on the coast, that's where the big show is right now. So what we have to wait for here in Bedford and across the western Appalachians is for this storm to wrap up and pull in a little bit and some of the snow to actually come back toward us. Now, that'll probably happen overnight tonight. But needless to say, this area is ready for a snow. It's the headline in the Altoona paper tonight. And nonetheless, a lot of the road crews are just sitting on, you know, the mat. We came to the Pennsylvania Turnpike, and a lot of the places where you can pull off, the road crews are just sitting there waiting for, obviously, the action to come on in. So they're definitely prepared for the storm. Local high school football has been canceled tonight. There's a big tournament here, so they're ready. But nonetheless, this is one of those things where you just got to kind of sit and wait and say, hey, I may have not blown the forecast, but just not anticipated when that transfer was going to occur. But where the transfer has occurred, it is quite fierce this evening, as we have quite a situation moving up the eastern seaboard. And to talk to us about that, let's go to Mike Seidel in North Jersey. Mike, what's going on tonight?
And Jim, you're quite right. This is where the show is tonight. We're here in Sandy Hook on the North Jersey shore, and the winds are howling in off the Atlantic tonight around 40 to 45 miles an hour. Gusts will likely approach or exceed 50. We have horizontal rain tonight. Tides will be running a bit above normal, and we do expect the possibility of some minor coastal flooding over there on the western side of the Long Island Sound. We should be okay right here because high tides at 7:36, and the worst of it will be coming after that point in time. Let me give you an idea of how strong the wind is blowing, because we don't have any vegetation and you can't see the waves, but you can get an idea of how strong the wind is blowing. It's coming right at my back. We're getting horizontal rain again. The worst of this should be over later on tonight when the wind shifts from the east around to the south and southwest. That'll be an indication the storm has gone by. One thing we don't have to worry about is snow and ice, with temperatures tonight staying in the upper 30s to near 40. So again, beach erosion, maybe some minor coastal flooding, but again, just a lot of wind, a lot of rain, a typical nor'easter here on the Jersey shore. But for rush hour tomorrow morning, it will be out of the way in the tri-state area. We'll keep you updated here from the Jersey coast. Back to you, Mike.
Thanks a lot, Mike. You need to get inside and dry off for a little while. We'll be talking to you again. That's Mike Seidel at Sandy Hook, the northern edge of the straight part of the Jersey shore, getting battered by some wind. And let's take a look at the latest on this. Storm warnings are flying for winds of up over 55 miles an hour at time, all the way down from Fenwick Island, Delaware, to the Canadian border. Ambrose Light Station, or Ambrose Tower, called both at times, in lower New York Bay, has been reporting winds averaging 40 miles an hour, and the latest gust is to about 47 or 48. That's really close to where Mike is, so he is getting battered by some winds approaching 50 miles an hour right now. And that wind will bring the high tide into his location 7:30 or 8 o'clock tonight, not too long from now. In Long Island Sound, it takes till about 11 or later for the tide to go high, and depending on how much water sloshes in there, you could have some flooding. So we have a coastal flood warning going on, mostly minor, but there is a chance that some of the bays and inlets could come up to moderate levels, maybe 2 feet or more above normal if it really winds up. And our low is winding up so far. In fact, it seems to be stretched out. We have almost a calm area down around Cape Hatteras, North Carolina, and even a wind shift around Wildwood, New Jersey. So our low is becoming stretched out right now, but ahead of it, where Mike is, the wind's still plowing on in from the east-northeast, gusting up into the 40s. That's the rain, that's the wind. Then we have the snow west of about this line. It changed back to snow in Raleigh-Durham, North Carolina. We've had some amounts that have gone up to 6 to 10 inches in this area. So the snowstorm continues, and looks like Jim will see some snow before all is said and done tonight, although so far it's been very, very minimal. Now the forecast goes like this. Some areas of 6 inches or more from parts